name and what do you do?
My name is Gary Wales, and I call myself a retro designer, which means I'm able to go back for the last 100 years, steal everybody's design, roll them up in a big ball, and then come up with my own designs and improvements. And this is what we do. What makes me really passionate about restoring these cars and building them and designing them is that we're saving these cars for posterity. That's really important. You'll notice every car that I have here has basically been a derelict, and people would say, well, what are you going to do with that? Well, what we're going to do with that is we're going to create something that is both pleasing and fun, and it's back on the road. It may not be exactly as it was originally made and delivered, but it's back on the road, and we hope making people very happy to see it.
Welcome to an episode of Jay Leno's Garage. We've got a couple of Rolls Royces here to show you today, but very special Rolls Royces. You know, when I first came to California, got interested in cars, right, I always hear about this guy somewhere in the valley named Gary Wales, who did just incredible body work and mechanical work. He built all sorts of specials. He restored cars. In fact, recently a Bentley he restored, I believe, was the highest price ever gotten for a Bentley. And I happened to bump into him the other day at a car show, and he had these two Rolls, and there were so many people crowded around the cars, they couldn't get near him. So I said, Gary, can you bring them to the shop? So they brought him over here, and we're going to show them to you. Gary, how you doing?
I'm doing great.
Well, there's
great,
the Bentley right there. That's the Frenet Bentley. What year is that one?
1947.
47, okay. Now, tell people what we have here.
Well, Jay, what they started life off in 1937, they were both built within a few months of each other, and they were both big, giant four-door sedan, chauffeur-driven cars. Well, in 1939, when London started to be bombed, the one family donated their car to the war effort, and it was converted into an ambulance hearse by the City of London that saw heroic service throughout the war. End of the war, pretty much a shot-up derelict. The other car was sent to Puerto Rico, so I found them in the mid-80s, bought them, brought them home, removed the offending coachwork, and then restored the chassis as they would have been delivered by the factory to the coach builders, and then just let them sit and enjoyed my new babies for 25 or so years.
This is your own design, your own body style, and beautifully done. Do you have a vision in your head? Do you sketch it all out as a draftsman would? I mean, how do you do it?
I flunked ruler reading, so I can't sketch anything, a straight line, but it's in my head.
Okay.
And I've kind of always subscribed to W.O. Bentley and Rolls' advice, and they said it prove on perfection. So the differences on these cars that on any other Rolls in the world is that I removed the engine, transmission, and firewall, just slipped them back 18 inches. And a twofold reason, gives it a nice, long, beautiful hood.
Right.
Plus, it gives it a proper weight distribution. The other thing that always bothered me is that the most iconic radiator shell in the world is the Rolls-Royce, and they put one single hood hinge down the center, never made sense. So I put double hinges on it. So it actually matches the configuration of the car.
Yeah, nicely done. And which engine does this have?
This is a 4.25 liter engine.
Okay.
So it's called the 2530 chassis. So of the small horsepower cars, it's the largest of them.
Well, you know, it's fascinating. If you go over the car and you just see all the little design things that he's incorporated here. Well, like this here with the hood, the cut of these fenders. This is very French looking, those fenders. I know you like French coachwork.
They are.
Is that where the idea came
from? Yeah, they're basically from the turn of the century Labradette, which was probably one of my favorite coach builders.
And it works as a fender, but no, I mean, the way you've got the bend exactly the way it should be. Yeah. And this beautiful woodwork, is this steam bent? Is that what that's called?
No, I'm very fortunate. The fellow across the street, John Maddox, was president of the Antique Boat Society. John came over and he cut these and he figured it out, and then we wrapped them all, and I put it on aluminum back first. So we've got these very, very strong fiberglass, and it's just this component part. Everything else from the doors on are all aluminum. Everything is aluminum.
But this is what wood, obviously.
This is Philippine mahogany on the top. It's Honduras mahogany on the side, and the difference of the color is due because of the density of the wood.
And what is this winch? Did you cut that, or is that a windshield from?
No, we cut that and designed it. You notice there's one spot in here that I kind of like. That's a little center windshield. And the reason for that is if you walk back here, Jay, you stand right here, everything goes from the center line, and what is showcased in the middle of that little showcase?
That. Yeah.
It's your Flying Lady, Spirit of Ecstasy.
Yeah, yeah, it's beautifully done. And people don't appreciate how hard this kind of workmanship is to do. Well, explain what this is here.
That is the little dash light.
Oh, of course. I see.
And then, you know, for map lights and whatever else, so your co-driver can tell you where you're going.
And this looks to be the original dashboard, is that
it
correct?
It is. Yeah. This is your start. This would, when in cold weather, you'd push it to start here,
right,
and that would choke it, and as it warms up, you just move it down until you get to normal, and you've got your normal throttle linkage, which you're certainly familiar with, just for adjustment and so forth.
Beautifully done, of course, the famous Rolls-Royce plate there. Yeah, nicely done. And actually, both cars are exactly the same. Can we open the hood?
Sure, absolutely.
And of course, that's the Rolls-Royce there. That's the smaller motor.
Yes, it is.
And look at the beautiful shroud he made here for the fan. That's the kind of detail work I like to see. You know, a lot of guys build stuff, you open the hood, and the finish end of the hood isn't as good as in the outside. All of Gary's cars are like this. Just beautifully, beautifully done. And you can see, just by the little bit of grime and wear and tear, these are cars that get driven. These aren't show cars. Nope. I see you out going through the hills of Malibu all the time. And they always go out as together. They're, for some reason, he's a little odd that way. And these Marshall lights, these are the most beautiful headlights of any vehicle.
Right. But come on, let's drive.
Thank you.
Let's do it.
The great thing about this car is it's been driven a lot of miles, and you notice when we looked at that rear deck, there's no cracking or anything in the wood. That's kind of a testament to the build quality, that she's not flexing. You know, a lot of old cars, especially wooden cars, many miles as this one has on it, they get all cracks and glazed over, but this one doesn't. I feel like the Great Gatsby driving this thing.
Yeah, makes you feel good every time you get in. You gotta smile.
It's a really comfortable car to drive. Boy, there's nothing more enjoyable. It feels quite modern, steers nicely, handles nicely. I love being a chauffeur in this car.
Yep. I want to thank Gary Wales for bringing both these, and Andre certainly thank for bringing both these cars by here. If people want to get in touch with you, how do they do it?
Just email me, glwales, W-A-L-E-S, at earthlink.net.
There you go. Oh, you're going to hear from people.
See you next week.